Apache Kafka is the most popular streaming data platform out there. And because of its widespread use, many developers are looking for ways to build applications and services on top of Kafka data streams. In this screencast, I'll demonstrate how to create a REST API from an SQL query over a Kafka stream using Tinybird. Let's jump in. So this is the Tinybird UI, and our first step is to create a data source from a Kafka topic. So I've set up a Kafka producer that's streaming some events from the fictitious Tinybird swag e-commerce store, and we're going to connect to a topic that's publishing the sales of products from that store. So we'll click the little plus icon here next to data sources, select Kafka, and then step one is to create a connection to our Kafka server. So we'll enter the Bootstrap server, give the connection a name, and then the connection key, secret, and SSL mechanism, and then we'll click connect. Now, after you've successfully connected, you'll see this list of topics. In this case, the topic we're interested in is called Z Sales. So let's scroll down, we'll select that topic, and then we're gonna enter a unique group ID. You can choose whatever you want here. Now, once you connect to the topic, you'll then have the option to preview the data and edit the schema before creating a data source from that Kafka topic. For now, let's just use the default schema. So we'll click Create Data Source. Okay, now we have a Tinybird data source storing those events that are streaming from this Kafka topic. You'll see the new events hitting the data source as you click refresh. Now let's take a look at the schema real quick before we start querying, just so we know what we're working with here. And you'll notice that Tinybird has automatically flattened that nested JSON into some discrete columns, and Tinybird has also inferred data types for the columns generated. Now, looking at this schema, let's say we want to create an API endpoint that gives us the top products purchased with a certain promo code over a time period. And we want that API to accept the promo code, a lookback period, and the number of products to return as parameters. So let's build a pipe to do that. Now from the data source, we can click Create Pipe to start writing our SQL query. Now let's name this pipe Top Products Promo Code. And in the first node, let's write a query to get the total number of purchases made with the promo code SPEEDWINS22 grouped by product over the last 5 minutes. So I'll just quickly write that SQL query and you can follow along. Okay, so that first node gives us the result that we want, the number of sales for each product with that promo code over the last 5 minutes. Let's rename this node Sales by Product. Now let's create another node to get the top sold products. And this one's actually really simple. We probably could have done all of this in one node, but no worries. I'll just drop some SQL in there, and then there's the result with the top three products. Let's rename this node Endpoint. Okay, we can now publish this as an API by coming up here to the top right, clicking Create API Endpoint, and selecting the node, and there you go. You got an API. But this API doesn't have query parameters like we wanted it to, so let's give it some. So we'll go back to the SQL in our pipe and use the Tinybird templating language to create some query parameters. First, we wanted to be able to pass the promo code. So let's do that with some double curly braces, which indicate a query parameter definition. This one will be a string. We'll call it promo code. Give it that same default value, add a description, and then we'll also make it required. Now let's also add a lookback parameter. So instead of just looking back 5 minutes, it'll be the same thing. We'll add a double curly braces. We'll make this a uint 16, default value is 5. Add a little description here. And then this one is also required. And finally, let's add that last one to define how many products we get in the result. So we'll change this limit to a uint 8 parameter. I'm gonna call it n, default is 1. And then we'll give it a little description. And we'll also make it required. Okay, let's go back to that API, copy it, we'll try it out. And now let's try a different promo code and get the top two products. And you can actually see that we get a different result by updating those parameters. And that right there is how you create a real-time, low-latency API from a Kafka stream using Tinybird.